I have got this LG mini split air conditioner circuit board. Its 7-segment display is not working fine. You can observe from the condition of the display that someone has worked on it, but he couldn't repair it. The second problem is that the remote control is not working on the circuit board. Let me power on the circuit. You must have heard a beep sound from the circuit. The display has not turned on. I have tried to set this universal remote on the circuit, but it didn't work. I will cut off the electricity from the circuit board. I will check the display. This LED light, which has KW written above, seems fine. However, the LED indicating the power light seems to be damaged. I will remove this cover from the above to better know what other LED lights are burned. These are the 4 points on the back of the display to remove this plastic cover. These points have been heated and then expanded to make a joint. I will press these upward. And I hope the cover will move out. It has started to move out. I will keep this tweezer inside it. I will try to move the rest of the cover with the help of another tweezer. The cover has moved out from this side. Also from the other side. Some of these LED lights are burned as they are black. Or someone has worked on them. The yellow LED lights are okay, but those that have changed their color have turned brownish. I will now confirm how many LED lights are between them. So, to test these LED, I will use this LED backlight tester. I will turn it on. The benefit of this tester is that while testing the LED lights, it automatically adjusts the voltages. The same voltages will be shown on the tester as on the LED. 300 DC voltages are shown on the tester's display. I will test all the LED. The positive and negative probes of the tester should be placed on the correct polarity of the LED, then it will work. It is showing 6 volts and sometimes 3 volts. The voltages are adjusted automatically. The tester probes could be attached in the wrong polarity to the LED. I will change the side of the probes. I will attach the probes. The LED has started to glow. The voltages on the tester were adjusted automatically to 3 volts. I will test the rest of the LED lights. This LED is not glowing. I will change the sides of the probes. This LED is not glowing, voltages are 2 volts on the tester. Let's check the rest. I will check these LED, which have changed their color. Nothing happened, let's go to the next. The one that is shorted will make the rest of the LED glow with it. This next is glowing, but its brightness is very low. This next LED is also the same. This last LED is not glowing, but the rest are glowing. Now, before desoldering the bad LED light from the circuit board, I will have to check its main circuit board for any faults. If the microcontroller is not making the signal out, it is also a problem. I have studied this section of the circuit board. A couple of capacitors were mounted here, and they have been removed from the circuit. I will solder a new capacitor here. Before it, I will check whether the microcontroller sends signals to this Darlington array. After that, this Darlington array and these 3 transistors all together turn on the display. And this is how the display works in a sequence. Thus, we get the numbers on the display. I will remove the display's connector from the circuit board to check it. I have removed this display because it has a short circuit. So, I will test the signals in the circuit board. To test these signals, I will use an oscilloscope. I am soldering this wire to the ground pin. To test the signals, I am taking the ground from here. I will press the button to power the circuit. I will place the oscilloscope probe on the Darlington array pin number 1. Let me press the auto button. No signals are shown here. I will check on the next pin now. I have pressed the auto button again. The signals are passing here on the 2 number pin. I will check on the next pin now. The signals also pass from this pin. The DC blower motor is not installed with the circuit. It could show its error code. The signals on these pins from 1 to 7 are received from the microcontroller. Let's check the output on pin number 15 of this IC. Yes, the output is passing from here. The oscilloscope shows the signals. For consolation, I am checking the output on this other pin. Yes, the signals are passing. We have confirmed that the microcontroller and the Darlington arrays are working fine. Now, I will replace these LED lights with these new LED lights. The already installed LED light is white in color. The LED lights I have are orange. The color is not a big issue. This connector is made of plastic. I will use this polymate tape to prevent heat transfer on the connector. I will stick this tape on this connector. The heat will transfer less on this connector now, because this polymate tape can bear heat up to 280 degrees. I will check this LED with the multimeter to see if it turns on or not. The LED light is turning on. I am checking this LED light also. This LED is also fine. All the LED lights are soldered and working fine. I am installing the missing capacitors on the circuit. I have connected the wires to the circuit board, and I will power it on. I have pressed the button on the circuit board. It has turned on, but only a single digit is shown on the display. I will check it with this universal remote control. I have checked all the codes on the remote control, but the display is not working with the remote. Now, let's talk about this IR receiver. It receives the signals from the remote IR transmitter and sends them to the microcontroller to turn it on wirelessly. Let's check if it is bad. I have power on the circuit. I will check the voltages on the IR receiver pin. The pin in the center is the ground. 5 volts should be on the pin on the right. The pin on the left is the output pin, where the signals move towards the microcontroller. I have placed the negative probe of the multimeter on the ground pin and the positive probe on the input pin. 4.86 voltages are passing through these pins, which means the IR receiver may be bad. I have removed the old IR. This is a new IR receiver. I am installing it on the display. It is the same model. I tried to turn on the circuit with the universal remote, but it didn't work, so I got its original remote. I will turn on the circuit with this remote now. I am pressing the on and off button. The IR receiver is still not working after being replaced with a new one. I will test it with a different method to determine whether the IR receiver works. The 5 volts are passing through it. I will check whether the signal is moving out from the output pin or not. I will check it with the oscilloscope. I have attached the ground probe with the pin I soldered. The positive probe of the DSO I am putting on the output pin, which is on the right side. 4.32 volts are shown on the oscilloscope. I will press the power button of the remote. Watch the oscilloscope. When I press the power button on the remote, the signals start to generate on the oscilloscope display. This means the IR is fine. This pink wire over here takes signals towards the microcontroller, which I have traced. This resistor is attached between the IR and the wire. I will check the continuity between the resistor and the wire. The beep sound can be heard. However, there is no continuity between the resistor and the output pin of the IR, which means there is a disconnection between the R13 resistor and the IR pin. I am powering on the circuit. It has powered on. I will turn it on with the remote. Yes, it has started to work with the remote. It is showing 8 on the display now. Now, let's see why the display segment on the left is not working. To understand what is wrong, we must again understand these three transistors and the Darlington array in the circuit board. Some signals pass through the Darlington array, and some through these transistors, which eventually turns on the LED lights. The Darlington array passes negative signals for the LED light. These three transistors are PNP transistors. The work of these transistors is to send a positive supply to the LED lights to make them work. I have already checked the display connector wires, and all wires are fine. I will now check whether the connector wires are connected to the LED lights. I have placed the probes on the red wire. Let's see which LED it is connected to. It is connected with the LED 3, 1, 4, and 2 left side. One of our segments is completed. I will now attach the probes to the brown wire. The brown wire is connected with the LED light pins on the right. I have put the probe on the black wire. No beep is shown on the left LED lights with black wires. This means the link between this wire and these LED lights on the left is disconnected. You can see I have cleaned some of these points. The solder mask of the area I cleaned, I have put one probe on it. The other probe is on the black wire. The connection is okay till here. But when I put the probe on the other side of the LED lights, they are disconnected. This means something is wrong over here. I will fix it, and then let's see what happens. I will now check whether the black wire is connected to this segment of the LED lights. Yes, it is okay now. I have power on the circuit board. I will turn it on with the remote. Now, all the segments of the display are working. I will put this cover on the LED lights. We can see 21 degrees on the display now. I will change the temperature with the remote. The temperature is changing fine. It means it has been fixed. Thanks to all who are supporting on Patreon, this is the list of our patrons. You can also buy me coffee on Patreon. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe, thank you.